Hello, viewers of Sounding Board, and tonight we're going to talk about Masters of the Universe Flextreme figures by Mattel. I don't think these figures ever made it past the test market because they have He-Man and Skeletor, and the only place that ever they ever popped up when it was Big Lots, and usually Big Lots has toys specially designed for them, or they have special repaints, or they pick up toys that were made to test market in small areas to see how well they sell if they want to go elsewhere with them, and they just put them out there. Or these are just overseas figures that just didn't sell, that they had to dump them somehow. But this is a Flextreme figure. And I wonder if Mattel actually had the Flextreme figures planned for actually a WWF line originally. Because the figures have this package and they have one arm out to show you how flexy they are. And they're not very flexy even in the package. But so let's take He-Man out and see how flexy he really is. He's kind of sort of an oversized Bendem that doesn't bend. And it looks like he was supposed to have accessories because his hands are kind of curled up to hold something. Like maybe a power sword axe or power sword shield. He has a notch back here which was planned for probably something too. Because the notch isn't there to help him bend. Figures are so thick. They're like the old WWF figures but posed in a really awkward position. But it is a way to get a He-Man figure that's about the size of your wrestling guys this time. He's still shorter than a Mego, but you can at least use him with your wrestling guys if you wanted. But I think most kids in a fight will use these to throw out their brothers. And I think these are more like the old LJN WWF wrestlers, which were dubbed by some people dog toys, because they're just posed in one model and they're thick like a rubber dog toy. These have the same problem. There's no real mobility to them. They're supposed to be flexible, but the flexibility is non-existent. So I can see why these were sold through Big Lots. I just think Mattel realized they're not going to sell. Let's just close them out and just sell them through as a quick sale through Christmas. And then whatever's left, Big Lots can keep on their shelves. But what do you think of these? Do you think they're kind of cool? Is this something you'd want to put in your Master Universe line of collectibles? It's hard to say, but it is a Mattel product, and it technically is a He-Man toy. It's not an off-brand where it's sub-licensed by Mattel to make a figure, like the birthday cake little figures. This is a real Mattel figure, and he's part of the offshoots of the Master Universe lines. But until next time, this is The Sounding Board, signing off. Oh yeah, I forgot one more thing. I forgot to show you the figure from the all sides. There's his front, his side, his back. As you can see, there's the notch right there. The other side, and we're back to the front. Now, until next time, this is the Sounding Board, signing off.